Welcome to the lecture number 2 of development of surfaces. In this particular lecture, we will be discussing the development of the solids after sectioning the solids. A pentagonal prism of 30 mm base side and 50 mm axis is standing on HP on its base, with one side of the base is perpendicular to VP. So one of the base edges is perpendicular to VP, and it is cut by a section plane inclined 45 degree to HP, and it passes through the midpoint of the axis. So draw the development of the lateral surface of the remaining solid. It says lateral surface of the remaining solid. So here we will see, okay, here is the simple position. So the pentagon, the characteristic view of the pentagon is drawn with one of the base edge perpendicular to VP. So I named it, and here I have the front view of the corresponding solid. And now I'll draw the cutting line, and I get the corresponding cutting points here. Okay. Now I will make the development, development of the entire solid here, the complete pentagonal prism, and then I will transfer these cutting points to the corresponding development, and I will join the points to get the final development solution. That means the development of the remaining solid. So here I have drawn the rectangle. Okay, I've drawn this development parallel to this one in order to transfer these points easily. Okay, you can even draw this rectangle somewhere else, but you'll have to measure this height and you can transfer the points. So this is easy if you can draw the rectangle which is parallel to the front view of the pentagon. So I have drawn this lateral surface with a length which is equal to 5 times the base edge 30 mm, and the height is equal to, or the width of the rectangle is equal to 50 mm, which is the height of the prism. Now I'll name it, and I have A, the lateral edge AA here, A, B, C, D and E, on which I'll get the corresponding cutting points also. So I'll transfer these points to the corresponding lateral edges, and I will join them to get the final answer, which is the development of the remaining solid. Okay. So next we will see a square prism of a 40 mm edge and a base 65 mm height stands on its base on the HP with the vertical faces inclined 45 degree with the VP. So 45 degree with the VP. A horizontal hole of 40 mm diameter is drilled centrally through the prism such that the hole passes through the opposite vertical edge of the prism. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the prism. So in this case, we have the square prism which is kept in the corner condition such that one of the vertical faces are inclined, see, the corresponding to this base edge, the face is inclined 45 degree with VP. A horizontal hole of 40 mm diameter is drilled centrally through the prism such that the hole passes through the opposite vertical edges of the prism. That means the circular hole, because the diameter is given 40 mm, the hole is a circular one which passes from this end to this end. It's a through hole. Now draw the development of the lateral surface of the prism. So I have drawn the characteristic view in the corner condition. Now we have the corresponding front view. Okay, so the hole has been drawn here, with the center of the hole is coinciding with the midpoint of the axis, because it says that centrally through the prism. Okay, and I've divided this circle into 12 parts, equal parts. So I these 12 points represent the circle. Okay, you can either take 8 or 12 to get these points. When the number is increasing, you will get more accurate curves. Otherwise, if the number is less, you can draw it very easily, but the accuracy might be slightly less. So here we have marked the 12 points onto the top view of the prism. Now I will draw, I can draw the development of the complete solid such that from A to B the length will be equal to the length of the base set. So you can see that A to B, so A to B is here, this is A to B, so this will have a length of 40 mm, so this is also having a length 40 mm. Now from A to 1 you will measure this distance and you will mark A to 1, here you will mark 1, and you will measure the distance from 1 to 12 and you will mark, sorry, it's 2, so you will mark the point 1 to 2 and 12 here, and this is the length to point 11 and 3, so you will mark the distance from A and mark point 3 and 11 and so on. So here I have this point A to B, point A and point B. Now I'll mark correspondingly point C, point D and point A. So that will make the complete length A, B, C, D, A. And I have also marked the points, intermediate points, which I get from the top view. Okay, get from the top view. So I'll mark these points on the developed edges like A, B, C, D, A. Now I will complete the development of the entire solid, so the lateral surface that will look like a rectangle. The total length will be equal to 4 times 40, the base edge 40 mm, and the width of this rectangle will be equal to the height of the solid. Okay. Now I will transfer these points. Again I have drawn this rectangle parallel to this, I have drawn this rectangle parallel to the front view so that I can easily transfer these points. Okay. Now I have the corresponding lines here, A1, 2, like this. So I can find out where is this particular points. So in, okay, I have 1, the line 1 is here. Okay, I can see that line 1 is here and I have to find where is the edge, where is the point 1 dash here in the front view. I'll transfer this, so this will be the point 1 in the development. Okay, we will see that. So I'll transfer that point here. Similarly, I'll transfer point 2 12 3 11, then 4, 10, 5, 9, 6, 8 and 7. So this comes here in ABC, that means ABC. You got the entire circle here, circular points here 1 to 12 of this, of circular point of this side. So you'll get another 1 to 12 here on ADC or CDA. So here you have a CDA, you'll get again another 12, a set of 12 points here. Okay, you can see that again you will get 12 points and I can join them, you will get the final answer, which is the development of the square prism with the circular hole. But you remember one thing, that when you have a prism, okay, when you have a prism with vertical or straight edges and you have a curved hole through that, in the development the hole will have a curved shape. Okay, you can see that it's an ellipse. It was initially a circle, but here it became an ellipse. Still, it's a curved hole. Okay. Similarly, if you have a curved surface which is being cut by a straight line or a straight hole is made, again you will get a curved hole shape in the development. Okay, you just keep it in mind. We'll see more examples. So the third question, we are discussing a right circular cylinder of base 50 mm diameter and axis 60 mm long is standing on HP on its base. It has a square hole of size 25 in it. Here we have a cylinder and the hole is in the shape of a square. The axis of the hole bisects the axis of the cylinder and is perpendicular to VP. The faces of the square hole is equally inclined with HP. Draw the projections and develop the lateral surface of the cylinder. So in this case, we have the characteristic view of the cylinder. Again, I have divided this circle into 12 equal parts so that it can represent 12 generators. And I have drawn the corresponding front view. Okay, you can see these are the generators. Okay, you'll have a total number of 12 generators there. So you can name it. The generators are named. Now you have the center of the axis, because it says that you have axis of the hole bisects the axis of the cylinder. So at the midpoint of the axis and midpoint of this square hole will be the same. So we can draw a square like this with center here joining or coinciding with the center of the cylinder. Now I will name it A, B, C, D, and you can see that you have four corner points, and it also cuts some of the generators. Okay, I will transfer those points in the top view. So here you can see that other than these corner points, we have some more cutting points here corresponding to which it's is cutting some of the generators. So I can transfer these points to the development. Okay, this rectangle represents the development of the lateral surface of the cylinder. You know how to draw the lateral surface. Okay, so I'll transfer these points. So the first point A is on the, you can see that it's not cutting any of the generators, but these corner points are always important. So you will transfer this point to the base circle. Okay, you can see that it is being transferred to the base circle, and we will consider the length. Okay, length of this arc, which is from 2 to A. 2 to A, this length. Okay, although we can't convert that directly into a straight line, we will take this distance in a compass and will approximately mark the position of this line A from the point 2. So you'll take this distance in compass and you'll mark point A here. Although it is not accurate, it is the easiest method to get an approximate solution. So we'll transfer this to get this line A. Okay, since we don't have a generator over there, and I will draw the line here and I will transfer the point A, to this particular line. Okay, so that I can mark the point A on the development. Then similarly, I will get I got the generator 3 here. Okay, the generator 3 on which I have two cutting points. So one is one cutting point here and another cutting point here. So this is corresponding to the generator 3. So on generator 3, I will mark the point, this point. Okay, this point is being transferred here and this point is being transferred here. So two more points you will get. Similarly, I will transfer next one is also, okay, this one, this point corresponding to which I don't have any generators. So I will transfer, okay, an arbitrary point here. Okay, you need not to divide this into equal parts. You take an arbitrary point here to transfer that to the top view and corresponding to which you find the generator. So from 3 I have to take this distance. So in this case I have to take this distance. So from 3 I have marked this distance here so that I'll get the corresponding generator for this point. So I'll draw the generator. I have the generator here. I'll transfer the point here. So this will be the corresponding point. Similarly here also you'll get one point. Okay, you can see that. Now you'll get 2 points over there. Again on the fourth generator you have B and T. You can transfer that also. And we'll continue the same process till we get all these points. Okay. Now this is about the square hole at this side. Okay, at this side of the solid. Now at this side also we have a square hole. Okay, so I'll get the corresponding points on this side. So this represents the point. So again you can see that you have a cylindrical surface which is cut by a straight hole. Again the hole will have a curved shape, so you can join them, it will be a curved shape. Now I can join the boundary which is not being removed. So this will be the development of the remaining solid. Now in this one, okay, in the previous example we haven't mentioned about how to draw the lateral surface of the cylinder. Okay, the lateral surface, you know that the development, in order to draw the development, it is very easy. So the length will be equal to the 2 pi r value and the height will be equal to the height of the cylinder. But when you divide this, okay, when you divide the cylinder into 8 equal parts, in the previous example we have divided that into 12 parts, so that you can consider 12 generators. Okay, in this case you have only 8 generators. So there will be one here and one will be here, and this is one generator. So 1 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So you have 8 generators. So when you develop this surface, where will be the position of these generators? Actually we are dividing this circle into 12 equal parts. So we are actually dividing the circumference into 12 equal parts. So here we have the development. So we'll have to divide this into 12 equal parts. But we know that the length is equal to 2 pi r. Okay. So if we are dividing the circle into 8 equal parts, you have to divide this 2 pi r into 8 equal parts. Okay. That will be a little bit difficult because you'll have to use the calculator, and the least count of the meter scale that you are using is also will not be adequate to mark the exact position of these generators. So in order to get that, what we will do is we will draw a line like this at an inclined at an acute angle, say 10 degree or 30 degree, something 10 to 30 degree, and this length should be equal to the perfect multiplier of the number of divisions. So in this case 8, so it should be the multiple of 8. So it could be 80 mm or 160 mm like that, or 240 mm like this. And what you will do is, since it is a multiplier of it's a multiple of 8, you can divide this line into 8 equal parts easily. Okay, you can divide that into 8 equal parts. So you have drawn a line with an acute angle from this end. Okay, this end you have drawn a line at 30 for an acute angle, and you have divided this into 8 equal parts. Now we'll join this end point to the endpoint of the development. So you'll get a triangle. Now from this each point, you will draw line parallel to this line. So we'll draw line parallel to this one, so that you can divide, so that you can divide this length into 8 equal parts. So from here you can draw generator, from here you can draw the generator, from here you can draw the generator like this. In this problem we are discussing a right circular cone of base 30 mm and a height 50 mm, which is resting on HP and cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP and inclined 45 degree to HP. And again, it's bisecting the axis. Draw the projections of the truncated cone and develop the lateral surface. So here I have the cone. I have divided that into 12 equal parts, which is representing 12 generators. And usually we will do the development like finding out the included angle theta using small letter r and capital R. Okay, and you will find out this angle theta, and you can complete this development. In the case of sectioned cones, it will be slightly difficult because you have to mark the generators over here. So after completing the development, if you are dividing this into 12 equal parts, that might be a difficult task. So the easiest method is you have to find out the value theta and you divide that into 12. Okay, so I'm taking 12 because I have divided the circle into 12 equal parts. So you'll get an approximate value. Okay, you can round it into a value theta dash. So corresponding to theta dash, I will draw a generator over here. So this is angle theta dash, which is equal to 1 by 12th of the included angle. So after getting this one, I'll mark the point 2. So I started from 1, this is 2, and I can mark. Okay, I know that all the 12 parts are having the same size and shape, so I can mark the third point by taking the straight distance, the shortest distance from 1 to 2. So I took this distance 1 to 2 in a compass, and from 2 I have marked the point 3 on the curve, and from here I marked the point 4 like that, so that if I join them like this, all these parts will have the same size and shape. But it's an approximated method, because when you complete this development, this included angle will be slightly different from what you have got using this calculation. So anyway, it will be the easiest method. Otherwise, if you are dividing the development after completing the entire development, the last portion will be either slightly larger or smaller. So in order to avoid that, you divide the included angle into a number of divisions and you approximate it, and first you will draw the corresponding portion here and you will take 12 equal parts so that you will get the complete development. So I will draw the development here. Now I will draw the cutting line and I will get the corresponding cutting points, and I will draw the section the top view, since in the question is asked to draw the projections of the truncated cone. Now corresponding to this point A, it is, the cutting point is being marked on a true length generator. Similarly, the cutting point G is also marked on a true length generators, but the other generators, you can see that the other generators, that is B, L, C, K, D, D, J, H, okay, E, I, F, H, etc. are not marked on a true length generators. But you know that in the development, all the generators are having true length. So you have to find out what is the exact position of this point B on a true length generator. So you have to transfer this to any of the true length generators 1 or 7. You can transfer this horizontally, either this direction or that direction. Similarly, the points C, K, you can transfer to the true length generator, so that you know the exact position of this point on a true length generators. Okay, we will see that. Okay. So here the first point is on the true length generator, and you have to draw an arc such that you will get A here also. This will be A also, because the generator 1 is repeating. We are starting from 1 and it should end at 1 itself. So this generator, you have the cutting point A here also. So you have to draw an arc. The arc means you are actually marking the position with respect to the center in the true length generator. So this distance and this distance will, okay, this distance will be the same. In order to get that, you draw the generator. Next, you will transfer the second point, the third point, fourth point, fifth point, sixth point, so that you can mark the corresponding points on the true length generators. So see, these are all true length generators. Okay, now you join them with a curve. See, it's a curve shape, because you are cutting a curved solid with a straight line. You will get a curve only, it won't be a straight line joining. You have to use freehand to join this one. Okay, so you will get the corresponding development of the solid. The next question, we have a cone of a 50 mm base diameter and 70 mm axis is standing on its base on HP, the simple position. It is cut by a section plane which is 45 degree inclined to HP, and it passes through the base end of the end generator. Okay, you have an end generator. I'll show you that, and draw the development of the lateral surface of the remaining solid. So we have the circle. Okay, in this case, we are dividing the circle into 8 parts, and I will get the corresponding front view. I have marked the generators. Now I will draw the cutting line like this. Okay, so you can see that the cutting line passes through. This is the end generator. The base end, the generator where it touches the base, this is a point. Through this point, the cutting line is passing. and which makes an inclination 45 degree. Okay, so you can draw the cutting line, you will get the corresponding cutting points. Transfer this one and we'll get the corresponding cutting points. So this will be the top view of the truncated cone. Now in order to develop the entire solid, name the cut off on the edge like A. From A you are cutting off, you are cut off on the solid, and so you'll draw the first line here. Better you draw this line parallel to the true length generator so that you can easily transfer these, cutting points. So the first line is being drawn. Now I have drawn the development. Again, you can follow the previous method of finding theta divided by 8, which is equal to theta dash, and you can draw the first generator at an inclination theta dash, and from this distance you can mark the point 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. So here I have the development, which is divided into 8 equal parts, and the ABCDEFGA have marked it. Now I'll transfer the cutting points. Okay, the cutting points are being marked. So you can follow the same method. You can mark the cutting points here. 1. Okay, this will be 1. This will be 2. Okay, this will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you can transfer these points to the true length line. And you can draw the arc. So the first point is here at the bottom itself, and the second point you can draw the arc. So you'll get a second and the eighth point. Now here you have another arc so that you'll get these two points and this one. Sorry, this one is being drawn here so that you'll get this point here. You can follow the same procedure in the previous one. The only difference is it's passing through the end of the base end of the end generator. Okay, so you can join them, you will get the final answer like this. Okay, so this is the final answer. In the next question, which is a square pyramid of base edge 40 mm and axis 65 mm long, has its base on HP and all the edges of the base equally inclined to VP. So all the base edges are equally inclined, means it is in a corner condition. It is cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP, okay, and inclined 45 degree to HP and bisecting the axis. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the remaining solid. Okay, so here we will see the initial condition, that's in a corner position. You have drawn the solid, and here I have the corresponding front view. Okay, the cutting line is passing through, okay, whether it is mentioned like it cut the section plane perpendicular to VP, inclined 45 degree, and bisecting the axis. That means this will be the midpoint. So through the midpoint you will draw the cutting line, and I will get the corresponding cutting points. Okay, this will be the top view, and now I'll have to draw. Okay, I got the cutting points here. ending points here. Now I can draw the development of the entire pyramid here. So if you can draw the first line, okay, first line parallel to this one, you can easily transfer these points. Okay, you can easily transfer this point. If you don't have a space over here, you can start drawing somewhere else, but when you transfer, you can find out the corresponding position and you take distance in a compass and you'll have to mark. Okay, so here I have the development. Okay, so this length I will measure. This is also already in the true length line, so I'll mark that distance here and I'll get the first point here. And since it is repeating A, this point also will be here. So this will be 1 and this will be 1. Now the point, okay, it's marked. The point 2 is at this distance in a true length line. So you have to measure this distance here and you'll have to mark it over here. Okay, this is on B as well as on D. Okay, so here we'll have, you have the point 2 and 4. That will be marked 2 and 4. Now this will be, okay, this will be the distance of 3 on the true length line. I'll mark it here and I can mark 3 over there. Okay, so if you can draw this one parallel to, can parallel to the front view, you can easily transfer this with the just horizontal lines. Okay. Now I can join them so that I will get the corresponding development of the remaining solid. The next question, we have a square pyramid of base 40 mm, side and axis 65 mm, as its base on HP, with the two edges of the base perpendicular to VP. So it's a square pyramid, two edges, so that should come like this. The top view should come like this. Okay, we will see. It is cut by section plane perpendicular to VP and inclined 45 degree to HP, bisecting the axis. Okay, it's something similar to the previous question, but only difference is the position of initial position of the solid is different. So here I have the solid, the pyramid and the corresponding front view. The cutting line is being marked. Again, this will be the midpoint. The difference is you won't have any cutting point here in this case, because you don't have any edge over this line. It's just an axis. So you'll get 2 points over here and 2 points over here. You can see that. So you'll get the corresponding points 1, 4, 1-4 and 2-3 over there. And this is the top view of the section solid. Now again, you can draw the development before which you have to find out the true length of the lateral edge. Okay, we have already seen that, because none of these edges are having true length in the front view, because none of them are parallel to XY line in the top view. So here I have one edge, I made it parallel to XY line, and corresponding to which I will get a lateral edge of true length line. So I can start from there. Okay, we have already discussed that. So this is the true length of the slant edge. So either you can draw the arc here, or if you don't have space over here, you can start drawing the first line somewhere else, but you have to transfer the points, transfer the height accurately. Okay, so I have drawn the first edge here, so true length of the slant edge. Now I have drawn the arc. Okay, I'll mark 4 points like this with the distance 40 mm, and I will join them to get the development of the entire solid. Okay, now I'll have to transfer the points to the corresponding true length generator. So none of them are true length lines, so I have to transfer them to the true length generator and have to find out what is the length. What is the length so that I can mark it on the corresponding generators. So I named it A, B, C, D, A. Now I'll join the bottom surface and I am transferring, okay, I'm transferring 1 and 4 to the true length line so that I can get this, I can get this length. Okay, so that I can mark it is on the A and D and A. Okay, you will see that. So 1, 4, I'll mark 1 here and 4 here. See. Now I'll transfer the point 2 and 3 to this one. So this distance I can mark on the edge B and C such that this point will be 2, this point will be 3. Okay, you can see that. I'll transfer that distance to 3 and I'll mark 2 and 3 over here and join them. I'll get the development of the lateral surface of the remaining solid. With this, we come to the end of the lecture number 2. Thank you.